Hello friends, welcome back to our course Mechanics of Solid. This is lecture number 8 and today we'll discuss about the analysis of bar arc in pump paper section. Okay. In the previous class, analysis of bar arc different cross section area we discussed. Metal may be different. Then we discussed with varying load, means one section to another section with load varying. Today we will discuss about the taper section, means section will be taper from one side higher diameter to lower diameter like that. And then we will discuss some numerical problem with varying load. Okay, so let's come here. When we are talking about the taper section, mainly two type section we discuss: bar of uniform taper with circular section, bar of uniform tapering with rectangular section. Okay, one is circular, one is rectangular. So let's first solve one problem for circular section. A taper rod has diameter d1 at one end and its taper uniformly to the diameter d2. One side d1 diameter, second side d2 diameter. Okay, at the other end, in a length l, length given as L as shown in figure. Okay, if modulus of elasticity of material is G, Young's modulus given us, find the chain length when subjected to an axial force P. This is one kind of derivation. So to solve this type problem, first we need to draw a diagram. And one more thing we required in this type problem: diameter at different pairs. In diameter with respect to length, we need to find out. How we can find out? First, change in diameter in length L each d1 minus d2, or length L here 2, here 2, here, or length L, change in diameter each d1 minus d2. Okay. So, rate of change in diameter, we can say change in diameter divided by length. Okay. Consider a element length of bar dx. Consider a small section, this small section of length dx at distance x from larger end. At distance x from larger end, the diameter of bar at this section each. Here, how much diameter you will get? Look here, in left side. Diameter d1. Okay, means if you go right side, this side diameter will decrease. How much decrease? Here we have rate of change in diameter into length, whatever length you are using. Okay, so here length is x, or x length we need to find out, so multiply with x. So that will be kx. Okay, so d1 minus kx, same thing written here. Cross section area will be equal to pi by 4 diameter square, but here diameter d equal to at this section diameter d equal to how much? d1 minus kx, so both square. Okay, now picture clear. Extension of element, how we can find out extension of any element? For this small section, we know that change in length, extension length del L equal to PL by AE. This is general formula, we know that. Okay, we will use same formula here. Extension of element dx, this is better, equal to P load, dx is length, A this area E. So this is extension only for this small section. If you want to find out extension of total section, how we can find out? We should do integration with respect to x. X will be 0 to L. Let's come here. Okay. Extension of the entire bar equal to del equal to I said no that here we should do integration of this dx with respect to x. Okay. So here with respect 0 to L we should do integration. So here 4, this 4 pi p e all are constant, so we should keep outside. Inside will be 0 to L dx divided by d1 minus kx whole square. Okay. So how we can do the integration of this one? For that we should know formula integration of a x plus b to the power n dx. What is solution for this one? For this one solution is a x plus b to the power n plus 1, okay, divided by a n plus 1. This is simple formula. Same formula we'll use here. Here a equal to minus k, okay, b equal to d1. Using that you can solve the formula n equal to 2. So from that we got here, if you put here ax plus b, same thing here, d1 minus kx to the power n plus 1, initially n equal to minus 2, so n plus 1 equal to minus 1 divided by a equal to minus k, equal to minus k, and n plus 1 minus 2 plus 1 equal to minus 1, so minus minus k went, and we got this one plus 1 by k d1 minus kx. Okay, we got that one. So here k came outside, inside is d1 minus kx and integration 0 to L. Okay, so equal to, put here same value here, and here k equal to d1 minus d2 divided by L, so we should write the same thing here. If you put x equal to L here, this one, no, if you put x equal to L, d1 minus k, how much k is d1 minus d2 divided by L. I am putting the value here, okay, x equal to L, so L, if you check this one, d1 minus d1 plus d2, okay, for that only d2 came here. If you put here in this, here x equal to 0, this term will be 0 and only will get 1 by d1, so 1 by d1 came here, 1 by d2 if you put x equal to L. Clear how it came? First time when we put x equal to L, we got 1 by d2. How we got here? You can see here this one. Okay. When we put x equal to 0, we got 1 by d1. Okay. Then del equal to 4pl divided by pi e d1 minus d2 inside d1 minus d2 divided by d1 d2. We got this formula. Okay. You can easily remember this one. Okay. For inform, diameter extension is this one, and taper rod is this one. If you see both formula, you will get both are similar to each other. Here it's varying diameter d1 d2, here only d. Let's solve another one problem. A bar of uniform thickness t, taper uniform from width b1 with d1 at one end to B2 at the other end in length L as shown in figure. Find the expression for change in length of the bar when subjected to axial force. Okay. So similar to previous problem, we should first find out, consider a element length dx at distance x from larger end. Once again, at distance x from larger end, we are considering one small element. Okay. So once again, we need to find out rate of change in breadth with respect to length. So this will be once again b1 higher side minus b2 divided by total length. We got this one. Hence, width at section x is at distance x from the left side. How much width we will get? Width at this side minus variation of width into x. So this is variation b1 minus b2 divided by l, changing length, changing of width with respect to length, this one is okay, into distance x. So this one we can write as k. We assume k equal to b1 minus b2 divided by l. Cross section area of the element equal to cross section of this area. This area will be how much? Cross section of this element will be T into B. But B equal to A equal to TB, B equal to B1 minus KX. Okay. Since force acting at all section is P only, throughout load is P only. Okay. So extension of element for this small element will be, as we know, the PL AE. You remember this one, I think. From that, for this small length, L equal to dx, so dx here. Now, here, P dx AE, area of this small element is B1 minus KX into T. Okay. Then total extension will be, once again, we should do integration 0 to L. Simply, P TE are constant. Okay. So remaining thing inside is here. This is remaining. We should do integration. Here, how we can do integration of this one? Okay. To solve this one, we should check integration of 1 by AX plus B is what? Okay. Integration of 1 by ax equal with respect to dx equal to 1 by a inside ln, okay, log ax. This is formula. Okay. So here we are doing integration from 0 to l. 0 to l. So 0 to L, here A equal to minus K plus B plus B. Okay. Here A equal to minus K, B equal to, from that put the value in this formula. Nothing is problem here, we should do only how to do integration. If you know integration, then this is easy. Okay, then this minus 7 inside, k outside, okay. B1 minus k equal to what is that? K equal to b1 minus b2 divided by l. Okay, this one is k x. So here, if you solve this one, you will get minus log b2 plus log b1. First time put x equal to l, second time put x equal to 0. So we will get finally this one. For circular section, we have formula. What is formula for circular section? For circular section, change in length equal to PL divided by 5 a 4 d 1 d 2 into e. Okay, for tapered section with rectangular section we should use this one, for circular section this one. Okay, then we will solve one problem. A circular alloy bar 2 meter long uniform taper from 30 mm diameter to 20 mm diameter. Calculate elongation of rod under the axial force 50 kN. Load is given as, here length is given as, d1 given as, d2 given as, and load P is given as, E value given as. Okay, so we can solve easily. First of all, you should write given data. This in kilonewton, so we should first convert in newton. That's simple. And here, this in gigapascal. So first we should convert this one in newton per mm square. How you can convert that one? To convert that one, let's suppose 140 gigapascal. Giga means 10 to power 140. Giga means 10 to power 9. Pascal means newton per meter square. So keep newton here. Per meter square. Okay. So you can say 1 meter into 1 meter like that. So that will be 140 into 10 to power 9 divided by 1000 mm into 1000 mm. So here you will get 140 into 10 to power 3 newton per mm square. This simple way how we can convert. Okay, so for elongation of the bar of taper section, we know that formula, this one, 4PL divided by pi E d1 d2. Simply substitute the value, you will get the answer. Nothing problem. Okay, let's solve another one problem. A round taper alloy bar 4 meter long is subjected to load as shown in figure. Find the change in length of bar by taking Young's modulus 120 gigapascal. This in meter. Okay, L is given as in 4 meter, but here diameter in mm, load is in kilometer, here gigapascal. First of all, we should make single unit. Okay, length 4 meter, so 4 into 10 power 3 mm, force is given 50 kilonewton, means 50 into 10 power 3 newton at one place. Okay, that's not a problem. We kilonewton to newton, that's simple. Okay, we'll solve that one. How we'll find out first force. Okay, so here, okay, modulus of elasticity 120 gigapascal. In previous problem we solved how we can find out this one, newton per mm square. Okay, from the geometry of figure we find that diameter of bar at B. Okay, in this problem most important thing we need to find out is first load per individual section. If I say this one section 1, section 2, section 3, we need to find out first P1, load on section, this section. We need to find out P2, we need to find out P3. Then only we can solve the problem. Second thing, what we need to find out? We need to find out diameter at here. Diameter at point A equal to given as 20. Diameter at point D given as 40. This 1 meter, 2 meter, 1 meter. So total length is 4 meter. Okay. Change in diameter with respect to length will be 40 in, sorry, 40 minus 20 divided by total length 4. So 5 mm per meter. Okay, so here to here is 1 meter, So in 1 meter, 5 mm will be increased diameter here. So we'll get dB equal to 20 plus 5 equal to 25 mm. Here to here, 2 meter, for 2 meter change diameter equal to, just multiply 2 here in this, 5 into 2, so 10 mm per 2 meter. So here plus 10, 25 plus 10, 25 plus 10 equal to 35 mm diameter point C. Okay, now we should find out force for this one, for this section and section. In lecture number 7 we already discussed how to find out force in different section. You can check that one. 20 mm, 25 mm, 35 mm, 40 mm. Now we need to find out force in individual section. So first consider a small section, this one. Okay, I'm simply writing like this. You can make paper section like this. Okay. Here this side 30. So this side also will be 30. Okay, for section AB is clear. AB. If I go for section B, writing better, we should draw here. But B C. Here 30 applied for section 1. So opposite force 30 will become here. 50 already given here. So 50 already given. So 50 will become here. So final will be how much? 20 this side. Especially less, so not coming properly. Okay, I'm writing from this one. Then 20 this side. So 20 we should apply this side. Clear up here? 20 kN this side, 20 kN this side. For section CD, 20 we apply this side, tensile. So here also tensile we should apply 20. Already given us 70. 70 given us. So final will be how much? Both we should plus, and we get final. Final will be how much? Here 50 we are getting. And already given us 50. Okay. Now we got the load P1, P2, P3. P1 equal to how much we got? 30 kN. PT equal to how much we got? 20. P1 is compressive, okay? So compressive. 20 kN tensile. In last section, 50 kN compressive. Now we can solve the problem. Total chain length del equal to, we can write del 1 plus del 2 plus del 3 like that, and here we will get delta 2 as positive because tensile del 1 and del 3 will be negative. And to find out del 1 we have formula PL divided by pi by 4 D1 D2. Here D1 is, you can say, dA dP, and del 2 will be PL divided by pi by 4 dP dC. Del 3 will be PL divided by pi by 4 dC dD. In this way you can find out del 1, del 2, del 3, then summation, you will get the final answer. Okay, check the answer, how it is given. First you find out diameter. Okay, that's necessary to find out diameter. Then AB subjected to compressive load 30 kN, part BC subjected to tensile load 20, CD subjected to compressive load 50. Whatever we solve, then you can easily solve the problem. Then no problem. Okay. Here you should always take care. One is tensile, so this will be positive, and here this is compressive. So whatever you get, you should use negative value of that one. And here also you should use negative del L1. So final del L equal to del L1 minus del L2 plus del L3. Let's solve another one problem. 2 meter long steel bar having uniform diameter 40 mm, length 1.5 meter in next 0.5 meter in diameter gradually reduced from 40 mm to 20 mm as shown figure. Okay. Total length 2 meter. You see in mm. Here 20 mm diameter and here 40 mm. Determine the elevation of this bar when subjected to an axial tensile load 200 kN. Okay. Given load value given as E value given us. Here once again, load in giganewton per meter square. So we know that how we can solve 200 into 10 to power 9 per giga, then okay, newton divided by 1000 mm into 1000 mm. So you'll get 200 into 10 to power 3 newton per mm square. Okay, here we can use two section. This one as section 1 and this one as section 2, and we can solve the problem. For section 1, PL by AE simple formula. For section 2, 4PL divided by E pi D1 T2. Simply you can solve the problem, no problem. Nothing is complicated here. Okay, so we will get the answer. Here, find the extension of bar so in figure under axial load 25 kN. Load P is same for all, P1 equal to P2 equal to P3 equal to P equal to 25 kN. Here diameter given us. First you should write here A, B, C, D, then it's easy to solve. Okay. DA given as 25 mm, DB equal to 25 mm, DC equal to 15 mm, D equal to 15 mm. E value same for all section, for section 1, 2, 3. For 1, for section 1, what is formula? PL divided by AE, E1 not required, P1 L1 divided by A1 E, for this is section 1, okay, for section 2, PL divided by pi by 4, D1 D2 E, here D1 D2 is DB DC. Okay, for section 3rd, PL2, PL3 divided by A3E, and after that finding that one, this one del 1, del 2, del 3. After finding that one, you can do summation, easily solve, you can solve, you can check the answer, okay. Solve yourself and check the answer. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. If you like this video, please like and subscribe.